Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Paper Mario. I am your host, Grandpyromania. And I'm sure many of you are wondering, Grandpyromania, we were wondering, why didn't you go on the train to Mount Rugged and start Chapter 2? Well, I'm glad you asked that, actually, because we actually have some loose ends to tie up here in Toadtown. One such being getting a completely useless badge, but being a sub-boss to do so. And first off, however, I want you to talk to this flower, because talking to plants are good. It doesn't mean you're crazy, no. It means you're normal. And it means later on you'll be able to advance the plot. There's actually about 7 of these, I want to say? I might be wrong, but anyway, as all good Samaritans, you intrude on private property. Because, you know, it's just what good Samaritans do. Anyway, let me just save first. Break down this block, if it wasn't obvious enough. And, oh my god, I see a new enemy! Guess what that means, folks? Yes, that means we get to tattle him with Goombario. Goombario, please, make our day. That is a Gloomba. There you are, the nasty Goombas that live in the Toadtown tunnels. They have 7 HP, 2 attack, and 0 defense. So they're just a more powerful Goomba. If, you know, that wasn't already implied with more HP. the action command for blocking them is still the same as normal Goombas. Not much else to say. You know, jump on them, hammer them, blow them up, hit them with a Koopa shell, you know, whatever's to your fancy. But there's no tricks and sleeves about these guys. And you get 4 star points per Goomba? Gloomba. And now, if you look really closely in that box, there's a spiked Gloomba. And since we don't have him tattled, we're gonna tattle him. So, tattle away, Goombario. They're spiked Gloombas! They're the ones that live in the Toadtown tunnels. They have 3 attack and 0 defense with 7 HP. Just like their Gloomba counterparts. Except you can't jump on them yet. Soon you'll get a badge that lets you jump on spiked enemies. Just not yet. I almost want to use Refresh, but no. We're going to have to save that for the sub-boss. Goombario's pretty much completely... Goombario's useless in this scenario. So I would suggest just bringing out Bombette or Cooper. I personally prefer Bombette because she can blow things up and does more damage than Cooper does. The only thing is that Cooper right now can attack all of them at once. I think that's actually the only advantage Cooper has. That and, if it's a Bob-omb, he can attack him without, you know, dying. Anyway, I'm an inch from dying, but I still live, which is always a good thing. I'm gonna blow him up. Sorry. And just like their normal, just like normal Goombas, you get 4 star points per each. I'm actually gonna go back and heal. So I'm back, and I completely healed. But I got into a fight with the Gloomba just there, and lost a lot of my recovery items. Anyway, ooh, Blooper! Yes, it's a gigantic Blooper. That's the mini boss of the Toadtown tunnels. Take it away, Goombario. It lurks in the dank pools of the Toadtown tunnels. It has 30 HP, 3 attack, and 0 defense. So, really what you want to do, all you can do is jump on them and use items, but so, Cooper and Bombette are completely useless. And when I say completely, I mean completely useless. You just gotta be careful, because he has 2 attacks. That drill thing he's been doing, which hits you for 3. And, then he has an attack that just spurts ink at you, which can get really annoying. Although, albeit, it's very comedic. That's the, timing there for the action command. But, yeah, all you have to do is whittle down his HP. There's not much else to really go into. It's not like he has super high-tech strategies that I need to cover that I know of. You just also need some luck, because this is a pretty hard boss at our level. Well, not Well, it's a pretty tedious boss at our level. It'd be much easier later on. And I'm in peril. That's not a good thing. I'm gonna show off Elstar. Basically, Star Spirits have an effect that you can use during battle, during Mario's turn, and each one differentiates. For instance, Elstar just now recovered me 5 HP and 5 FP, which, in a cinch, it was incredibly useful. Oh, and there was that ink. So, it does 3 damage. I never, like, ever got the timing down for that, so use Mushroom because I'm running low on health. That's never a good thing. And yeah, I mean, I kinda really don't know what to talk about at this point because there's not much to say other than I hope you guys beat him like I just did right now. He drops 20 star points for you guys. Aw, what a nice guy. And notice he doesn't die, he just jumps back in. I believe we fight him later. I'm not sure though. And that's a shrink stomp badge, which decreases an enemy's defense when you jump on them using that attack. And now that that's done, I'm gonna go save, just in case my power goes out, which would suck, and I would wonder how I'd get this Let's Play going, or this episode. And then we're gonna go up the pipe, and now we're gonna go take the... No, I lied. No, we're gonna go to Tasty first. I don't think I have any items, do I? No, not really, I don't want to give up. Good recipe is that you could, use honey syrup and make a... I forgot what it's called, something soda that recovers you for 5 FP, just like a normal honey syrup, but it gets rid of, like, Saz afflictions like poison and whatnot. Anyway, we're gonna be taking a train now. And chugga 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 chugga. And this train will take us into Chapter 2. And since I actually have time left, I'll be able to do a decent outro. Anyway, you guys like what you saw here? Subscribe, rate, comment. Press the yellow button in the top right corner of your screen. Tell your friends. I do parties over the internet. And I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Paper Mario.